Today, I will be breaking down the salaries in the field of architecture. So whether you are an architecture intern or a longtime architect or aspiring interior designer or want to go into construction, this really breaks down kind of all the paths you can take with an architecture degree and what you would get salary-wise. Keep on watching after this short intro. It is your girl Nat here. I'm the creator behind Unraveling Architecture. Please be sure to like and join our Discord. These salaries were reported in the year 2015 and 2017 by the US Bureau of Labor Statistics. And just FYI, the average rate of inflation since 1914 is about 3.24% per year, so I'm sure that these salaries have slightly increased to accommodate for this inflation rate. But today's number is just to give you a very basic guideline, what to expect with an architecture degree and moving up the professional ladder. How much can one make in architecture? Let's find out. And just keep in mind that all these numbers are medians unless I state otherwise. So starting out with architecture, if you are an architecture intern. So architecture interns typically need to work about 3 to 5 years to complete their APX hours and also have enough time to complete your AREs. It's a multiple test series that you need to pass in order to get your own permit signature and license as an architect. If you are completely confused as to what I'm talking about, please check out that video and that video if you are an international student. Now, the starting salary for an architecture intern ranges from about $36,000 to $40,000, but the longer you are holding your title, like with most jobs, you will get an increase here and there. So second year architecture interns averaged about $45,000. And if you are a fifth year architectural intern, you're looking at about $45,000 to $50,000 per year. Now, let's say you pass all of your AREs, you complete your APX hours, and now you are a licensed, registered architect. Congratulations, you're a baby architect. What does your salary look like for you? So on average, the starting salary of a baby architect, aka a newly licensed architect, with limited experience ranges from $52,000 per year to $65,000 per year. First year, newly licensed architects earned about 10% more than architectural interns or unlicensed coworkers. But if you have a lot of experience under your belt, expect to make around $70,000. Now, for an established architect, you've been in the field forever, right? And you're working at a firm. The average architect earned a median annual salary of around $78,900 per year. And like I said in the intro, this is according to the US Bureau of Labor Statistics. Now, the top 10th percentile of architects earned $137,000 per year, but this is just the top 10%. And I also found some disclosures that if you are a licensed architect working at a very like top tier prestigious firm, some people make upwards of $200,000 per year, which is crazy. But keep in mind that this is such a small amount of architects. Now, as we all know from all of these videos on my channel, architects can only get this title in this field from either getting a professional degree, 5-year degree, or a master's degree, a master's professional degree, whatever you want to call it, in a 2+4-year program. Now, let's say you don't want to go to all that school, you don't want to take the AREs, you don't want to do APX hours. Another option for you to pursue would be interior design. So interior design is a facet of architecture that is always used in an architecture firm. My firm that I interned at last year, we were always coordinating with the interiors department. And the average interior designer, according to Indeed, earns an annual salary of about $58,900. And this was reported in 2020, so that number's pretty recent. Now, what about engineering? Similar to interiors, some firms even hire their own internal engineers to work on projects, so everything remains in-house. So civil engineering all the time works with architects and architecture. And also keep in mind, civil engineering salaries depend on where you are located too. But according to salary.com, a civil engineer in training makes about $71,000 per year. And an expert civil engineering consultant makes about $133,000 per year. And what about carpenters or the world of construction? So carpenters on average earn about $45,000 a year. Construction laborers earn about $33,000 a year. Electricians, you're sitting at about $54,000 a year. Plumbers make about $45,000 a year. And general contractors earn a whopping $92,000 per year. And that's without spending a hefty sum at a traditional university to get degrees. Typically with the world of construction, you're probably gonna go to what's called a trade school, where they will just kind of focus on the skills and tips of the trade. And also keep in mind, with any profession, earnings are going to vary by location. Even for the entry-level, internship-level kind of salaries, that fluctuates a lot across America. So for instance, New York and Pennsylvania are gonna have higher salaries than for places in Tennessee, Alabama, Georgia, those kind of places. The average New York architectural intern earned about $41,000 per year, but interns located in the East, South, Central US earned an average of $34,000 a year. Salaries are so important. No one can change my mind on this, and it does matter. I don't think it's wrong for a person to choose this major because there's a stronger salary at the end of the tunnel over this major. And the way our society is structured requires a good salary for you to support yourself and pay off student loans, whatever you need to do. So that's why it's important when you are considering selecting a major in college or you're currently in architecture, curious about the salary breakdown. I hope this video was helpful, and it is super important to understand what you are in fact signing up for. Super important. Okay, I remember in high school that I was having this debate with my one friend, and she's from a very well-off family, and she was saying how salaries don't matter, like money can't buy happiness. And I understand that. Debt is really scary in America, and I wish student loans weren't really a thing. Whole nother video, I know, but it is just, it's so important to really be comfortable with what you're signing up for salary-wise and go from there. I hope that this video didn't appear superficial. Yeah, that's just my take on salaries, so it's okay if you decide to leave architecture to pursue engineering because you get a significant pay raise. Totally okay, totally fair. And I just wish you the best of luck with whatever you choose studying. I hope it's architecture, but yeah, just let me know. Let me know if there's any other videos like this one that I could help you guys out with. More than happy to help, and I will see you guys in the next video. Love you guys.